According to the IMF and the World Bank, Singapore is very rich. So rich that the US and the UK look poor in comparison. PPP GDP per capita in Singapore is about 87K. For the US, it's about 57K. And for the UK, it's about 43K. So, based on these figures, Singapore is 105% richer than the UK and 52% richer than the US. In this video, we'll first explain what PPP GDP per capita is. We'll then show that Singapore's riches are greatly exaggerated. PPP GDP per capita is a measure for comparing economic well-being across countries. It is constructed in three steps. Step 1, calculate GDP. Step 2, adjust for population to get GDP per capita. Step 3, adjust for prices to get PPP GDP per capita. Let's go through these steps slowly. Step 1. The 2016 GDPs of the US, Singapore, and the UK were about 18.6 trillion, 300 billion, and 2.6 trillion US dollars.
Achtung! Alle Figuren sind hieß wie die Jahre in US Dollars.
What do these numbers mean? GDP stands for Gross Domestic Product. GDP is the sale value of all goods and services produced in an economy, in a given time period, usually a year. Here's a simple example to illustrate. Imagine that in 2016, the US and Singapore produced only apples and absolutely nothing else. The US produced 18.6 trillion apples and each sold for $1. So 2016 US GDP was simply 18.6 trillion times $1, or $18.6 trillion. Singapore produced 3 trillion apples and each sold for 10 cents. So 2016 Singapore GDP was simply 3 trillion times 10 cents, or $300 billion. Now, US GDP is about 60 times Singapore's. So, is the average American 60 times as rich as the average Singaporean? Obviously not. US GDP is much larger because its population is much larger. For a better comparison of economic well-being, we must adjust for population. Which brings us to step 2. Simply take GDP and divide by population to get GDP per capita. For the US, that's 18.6 trillion divided by 324 million, or 57K. For Singapore and the UK, the calculations are similar. Now, US GDP per capita is 8% greater than Singapore and 42% greater than the UK. So can we say that the US is 8% richer than Singapore and 42% richer than the UK? Not quite. Imagine again that in 2016, the US and Singapore produced only apples. Each country produced an average of 10,000 apples per person. Since the two countries are equally productive, we'd like to say that they have equal economic well-being. But if apples cost $1 in the US but only 10 cents in Singapore, then GDP per capita would be 10K in the US but only 1K in Singapore. Not what we were expecting. The GDP per capita measure can be misleading, especially when prices are very different. For a better comparison of economic well-being, we must also adjust for prices. Which brings us to step 3. By custom, the US is the reference country.
Very nice!
Meaning that for the US, no further adjustments need be made. PPP GDP per capita is simply equal to GDP per capita. According to the IMF, the general price level in the US, as compared to the UK, is about 5% higher. In other words, stuff is generally 5% more expensive in the US than in the UK. So for the UK, we add about 5% to GDP per capita to get PPP GDP per capita. That's about 43K. Having adjusted for both population and prices, it is now legit to say that, based on PPP GDP per capita, the US, as compared to the UK, is 35% richer. Now, is the general price level in the US higher or lower than Singapore? Just for fun, hit pause and make a guess. Be specific. How much higher or lower? Three consultancies regularly publish global cost of living rankings, covering many cities. The priciest US city, according to all three rankings, is always New York or Manhattan. And all three consistently rank Singapore above New York. Since Singapore is pricier than the priciest US city, the general price level in the US should be lower than in Singapore, right? Wrong. According to the IMF, the general price level in the US is about 64% higher than in Singapore.
What?
In other words, stuff is generally 64% more expensive in the US than in Singapore. To be clear, we're saying that in an imaginary average town USA, where the price of everything is exactly the US average, stuff is 64% more expensive than in Singapore. If you've been to both the US and Singapore recently, you'll probably find this figure insane. So, according to the IMF, we must add 64% to Singapore GDP per capita to get PPP GDP per capita of about 87K. This is how we arrive at the fantastic conclusion that Singapore is 52% richer than the US and 105% richer than the UK. The IMF assumes the US is 64% more expensive than Singapore, and so Singapore PPP GDP per capita is 87K. If we instead make the conservative assumption that the general price level in the US is the same as in Singapore, the figure would be a more believable 53K, which would make Singapore slightly poorer than the US. And if we instead make the more plausible assumption that the US is 20% cheaper than Singapore, then it would be around 42K, or just below the UK.
Econ Cow is a new channel for educational videos, mostly on economics. I'm still trying to improve, so please feel free to leave me any feedback in the comments below. And of course, like, subscribe, and watch another video.